Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we learn how to write fractions and decimals, and we convert the following seven fractions to decimals. And in many cases, we have to round to the nearest tenth or hundredth, and we also introduce notation for repeating decimals. Once you know how to write a quotient in decimal form when you're dividing by a whole number, you can then write a fraction as a decimal. So here's an example. Write 3/4 as a decimal. So 3/4 is the same thing as 3 divided by 4. So we simply say 4 into 3. Now, we don't know if this is going to result in an exact decimal or not right now. So we're going to begin. We know 4 doesn't go into 3 by just adding some zeros and see what happens. So 4 goes into 30, let's see, 7 times. So 7 times 4 is 28. We subtract, and so we have a remainder. So remember, you can put another zero here to bring down that zero. 4 goes into 25 times, and we have a remainder of 0. So actually, 3/4 is exactly 0.75. Or 0.75. All right, so I want you to try one. How about write 3/8 as a decimal? So put the video on pause and use the same method and try it. Okay, so let's see. What are we going to do? We're just going to do our division again. 8 goes into 3. So it's, instead of putting 4, you're just dividing by the 8 here. And you're going to have to add a 0 here. Remember to write the decimal point up here. Same place it is right here. So 8 goes into 30. How many times? I think that's 3. So 3 times 8 is 24. All right, got a remainder. So put another 0 here so you could bring it down. How many times does 8 go into 60? That will be 7. 7 times 8 is 56. We still have a remainder, so we add another 0. And then 8 goes into 40 5 times. That goes exactly. So 3/8 is another fraction that could be written exactly as a decimal point. 3.75. Now, I may have said write 3/8 as a decimal and round to the nearest hundredth, in which case you would round it to the nearest hundredth. Would be what? You find the hundredths place, that's the 7, and since the next number is a 5, the next digit's a 5, this would have rounded up to 0.38. Sometimes you have to round it. Or you have to write the remainder sort of in fractional form. That's another way you might do this, and I'll show you some problems like that later. But not every fraction can be written as a decimal that terminates. In other words, you get a remainder of 0 as you go along. So let's try one of those. Write 1/6 as a decimal. All right, so let's try it. 6 into 1 point, we'll see 0.0. So we say 6 goes into 10 once, and we subtract. So we're going to put a 0 here. And then 6 goes into 46 times. So you got to put a 0 here and bring it down. 6 goes into 46 times. You might notice the same thing keeps happening. Every time I add a 0, I keep on getting 6 goes into 40. So you know what happens? This just keeps going on and on forever and ever. If you have the same digit go on forever and ever, the way we can write that is either you sort of show a pattern and then put three dots after it. Okay? That means, yeah, you get the idea. 6 is forever. Or what you could do is whatever digit or digits are repeating, you could just put a bar over it. This means take the 6 and keep writing it out like that. This is a shorthand form for it. You also might round the nearest tenth or the hundredth, so let's just round it to the nearest hundredth. If I wanted to round it to the nearest hundredth, I find the hundredth place right here, and since the next number is 6, it rounds up to 0.17. So 1/6 actually equals this, but 1/6 is approximately equal. I use a little squiggly equal sign to show it's not exactly equal, but I've rounded it to 0.17. All right, here's the next example. Write 4/9 as a decimal. Okay, so let's do our usual. We're doing 9 into 4, and we'll put 0.0 to get started. It's probably going to be some more zeros. So 9 goes into 40. I think that goes 4 times. Oh, and then 9 goes into 40 again. 4 times. This looks like that last problem I did, doesn't it? And that I keep on getting the same remainder here, so I'm still doing 9 into 40 again. That's 4. So as you see, this is going to keep going on and on and on. So to write it as a decimal, I could say, well, it's 0.444. Get the idea? With 3 dots after it. Or you could say, well, it's the 4 that's repeating. So I'm just going to put a line over the 4. That's a shortcut way of doing it. But let's say we wanted to round it instead. Round 4/9 to the nearest hundredth. What would that be? 4/9 rounded to the nearest hundredth. I find the hundredth spot here. The next digit is a 4, so it does not round up. It stays 0.44. Okay. And usually that's what we're going to do. We're going to be rounding more often than writing it this other way. But it's nice to know you could write this the other way. You also might have 2 digits repeating. It might be something like 0.13, 13, 13, 13. And you would then put the line over both the numbers. So let's just do one problem like that. All right, why don't you try this one? Write 5/11 as a decimal. See if you could figure out how to write it in repeating form, and then also round to the nearest hundredth. So put the video on pause and try this on your own first. Okay, let's go for it. So we have 11 into 5.0. So if 11 goes into 50 4 times, and we subtract, we have a 6, so we're going to have to add a 0 here, bring down the 0. 11 goes into 60 5 times. We subtract, right? Let's bring down another 0. 11 goes into 50 4 times. Remainder 6. Does this look like, you know, deja vu? You get the same thing over and over? So what's happening here is I'm getting a repeating pattern again. So we could say that 5/11 is actually 0.45, 45, repeating. So you get the idea. You have to establish a pattern. You should put like either 45, 45, 45, or at least 2, as you could see it. Now another way of doing it is it starts repeating right here, right after the first 4/5. So what you could do is say it's 4/5. That repeats. That tells you it's 0.45, 45, 45. And then rounded to the nearest hundredth, what would it be? Five elevenths rounded. Okay. So we look at the digit after the hundredths place, and it's 4, so I do not round up. I keep it just 0.45. Right, so here's the exact answers. These first two are exact. That's why I use an equal sign. And here's the rounded answer to the nearest hundredth. All right, let's try this one. Write 3/7 as a decimal rounded to the nearest hundredth. All right, so here's the key. If we know we're going to round it to the nearest hundredth, then when I begin, I could just put 3 point, and I want to only go out 3 decimal places, right? 3 places after the decimal point, because if I get to the thousandths place, I'll be able to round. So that's how you're going to start. We won't worry about how to write it as a repeating decimal. So go ahead and try this problem on your own by putting the video on pause and trying it all by yourself first. All right, so here we go. We write 7 into 3.000. You're going to put the decimal point right above where it is here. Remember, we're always dividing by a whole number here over on the left. I don't want to have 0.7. We haven't gotten how to do that yet. 7 into 30 goes 4 times. 4 times 7 is 28, and we subtract. Bring down the next digit. 7 goes into 20, think twice, right? It's 14. And 7 goes into 60. I think that's 8 times. And at this point, we could stop because we're only going to round to the nearest hundredth. So the question is, does it stay at 0.42 or go up to 0.43? And it rounds up. Since that next digit is an 8 in the thousandths place, so 0.42 is our answer. All right, let's try this one. I want you to write 15 27ths as a decimal and round to the nearest hundredth. So try this one on your own by putting the video on pause and then checking back. Okay, now some of you probably did this. You did 27 into 15.000. Am I right? Here's what I do. I notice that 15 27ths can be reduced, and then I do division. So it's a little trick. If you see you don't have a reduced fraction, reduce it so your division is going to be easier. So let's do that. If we divide the top and bottom by 3, I have 5 ninths. So I'm going to do 9 goes into 5.00. So let's see if we get the same answer either way. So 9 goes into 50 5 times. And then 9 goes into 50 5 times. And then we see what's going to happen here. There's that repeating decimal. So when I round it, I'm going to get 0.56. So my answer here is going to be 0.56 when you round it to the nearest hundredth. Now, would I get the same answer? In other words, if you did it this way, would you get the same answer? I hope so. How many times is 27 go into 150? Well, that's harder to figure out, but it does happen to go in 5 times. And then you have to do 5 times 27, which isn't that easy. What is that? I think 5 times 27 is 135. And then you bring down the 0, and then 27 goes into 150. Oh, that's going to go 5 times again. Bring down the next one. The important point is I will get the same answer, 0.56. But which is easier for you to do? Dividing by 9 or dividing by 27? You don't always have this choice, but if it does reduce, go ahead and reduce it. It's usually going to be easier to do your division because you'll have a smaller number in the denominator. All right, so we've done lots of problems where we are converting fractions to decimals and then sometimes rounding.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.